Jeremy, it's your girl Jackie, and I can't scratch my nose. Okay, sorry, got a little distracted there. It is Super Bowl Sunday, and I am filming a video before I head out to a Super Bowl party for you guys. That's how deep my commitment is to keeping you guys, you know, with the videos and stuff like that. I know that I kept you guys without for so long, so, you know, I'm committed, okay? I love you guys. I can't leave you without a video for too long. So I am just going to do my January favorites. I can't even believe it's already the end of January. Actually, it's February right now. It's February 2nd. What the hell? I am wearing my orange lips in honor of the Broncos, but I know that you guys are probably gonna ask what it is. Let me grab those colors for you. Everything I'm wearing is by NYX, so this is a very affordable lip combo. My hair got stuck. Well, it is NYX lip liner, and the color is called Pumpkin. And then the lipstick is NYX Diamond Sparkle Lipstick, and this color is called Sparkling Orange. I really, really love this combo, and I kind of forget about it all the time, and then, you know, anytime I feel like, why is my nose itching? Oh, it's my hair. Oh, okay. Anytime I feel like wearing an orange or coral lip, I kind of rediscover these, and I'm like, why do I not wear these more? So I was planning on doing a really quick tutorial for you guys, but it's raining today. Thank God. Okay, we're having a drought in California. Those of you guys not living in California, it's like we never get rain anymore. It's horrible. It is raining today. It's messing up my lighting, but you know what? I'll take it because I don't want to have a drought. Instead, I'm just going to do my favorites. So let me get right into it because I want to get to the party. So as always, I will be kicking things off. Ha ha ha, you get that? Kicking things off? Fine, fuck you then. This is by Jason. There's little accents and whatever there, so I'm sure it's pronounced fancier than I'm saying it. It is the Flaxseed High Shine Pure Natural Styling Gel. I got this at Whole Foods. Actually, my boyfriend got it for me. Well, you know, let's give him a name. Let's call him D, okay? Because his first name starts with a D, so we're just gonna call him D, all right? I'm always calling him the boyfriend, and people don't know if I'm talking about the same guy or a different guy or whatever. It's the same guy I've been with for a long time, but I don't want to reveal his first name just kind of out of respect, so we're gonna call him D. So he bought me this. We were at Whole Foods, and we were getting some food, and I was out of hair gel and I didn't feel like going to Walgreens, and so we went to the hair section, and just out of everything they had there, this was affordable, because some of those hair gels are really expensive, and I didn't really want to pay $15 for something that I wasn't gonna like. You know, I'd rather like try it out a little bit if I'm gonna spend that much on it first. So we found this one. This one was $8.99, so he got this for me. I had high hopes because I've used this brand skincare before and it's really good, but I didn't like the texture of the gel. I felt like it was really, really sticky. This is something that I would recommend for someone who wants a more textured hairstyle, like if you like to do spikes or something like that, but it just was really crunchy and it kind of made my hair kind of stand, like the ends were kind of standing out straight, and I think it's because the gel is almost too firm. It says firm hold, which I like, but it was too firm. So for me, it personally did not work out, and because of that, hated it. I need to do something about having this bed behind me because it's really minimizing the impact of my hated is. I'll figure it out, no worries. So the first favorite that I'm going to be talking about is by, I don't know. Okay, it's by Maybelline. Why did they not put the name on here? So it is the Lash Out Butterfly Mascara. I saw the ads for this and I was kind of on the fence about picking it up, but I was like, well, you know, I was out of mascara anyways and it was on sale. Regular price is $8.99. I paid $5.99. So what is cool about this is the brush. And so as you can see, it's a really unique shape right here. And so it's supposed to, this little piece on the end right here, is supposed to flare out the lashes in your outer corner, making them kind of like more fanned out and full looking. And it actually does work. It's pretty interesting because I was like, that's not gonna work. Just because I'm really skeptical about all these like fancy pants brushes, I feel like if the formula of the mascara is not that great, the greatest brush in the world is not gonna help, okay? But I actually think it's really good. The formula itself is decent. I mean, it's volumizing enough and it is lengthening enough, but I do feel that the brush really makes all the difference. So what I'm probably gonna do when this is done is try to use it with a different mascara, use the brush, and see what that does. I don't know why I didn't do that before. So the next thing I got, I am really, really excited about. I have been dying to try a lip tar from OCC Cosmetics for so long, and I got some gift cards for Christmas to Sephora, so I kind of took that opportunity to try out some new products, and I picked one of these up, and wow, is all I have to say. Absolutely amazing. The color I got is called Black Dahlia, and I'd heard so much about this color, and it is just like, oh my God, amazing. So let me just swatch it for you guys. It is this beautiful, like, deep, It looks like blood. Honestly, the texture of this, it looks like I cut myself. It is a deep blood red, but it has a little bit of black, but it's just so multi-dimensional and gorgeous. And I really like the idea of having blood red lips, and this is just perfect. And now it's gotten all over my hands. It is absolutely perfect. It is just one of the most beautiful lip colors I have ever used in my entire life. If you like deep, deep red lips that are almost black, this is perfect. And it came with a little brush. It came in this little thingy, and it came with a little lip brush to apply it with. And it was pricey. I think I paid $22 for it, but to me, this product is worth the price. I'm willing to spend a little bit more when it's a product that I feel is unique and something that I can't get with another brand. I really do feel like OCC has something that I have not found in other lip product brands, so I'm definitely excited about this. So this next product I got on Hotlook, and it is by The Balm, and it is their Time Balm Dandelion Skin Brightening Moisturizer, and I like this a lot. I really like moisturizers, and this one I especially like as a daytime moisturizer because I just really like the texture. It's very non-greasy. I still have that lip tar like all over my hands. I just really love the formula and the texture of this. And when it comes to what I'm applying in the morning, I like to get out of the shower. Once the seam of my shower has opened up my pores, I will put on a really good moisturizer and kind of let it absorb. And this one's really good for that because once it absorbs, it's really non-greasy, so it's not gonna have any effect on the primer or the foundation or whatever it is that I'm gonna wear that day. It's not going to intermix with that and affect the texture in any way. So I really like this a lot. It is a little bit pricey, but I got it on Hotlook for like half price, so I'm just probably gonna wait for Hotlook to have another sale with The Balm and just get another one then. Next item is from Sephora, and you guys saw this in my Christmas haul, I think. My mom gave me this. It is a Sephora eyelash curler, and the color is Rose Quartz, and it's actually a really, really good eyelash curler. I like it because the pad is very firm, so it does a really good job of curling up my lashes, and I find that my lashes hold a curl much better when I use this curler, and it's just really pretty. I know some people think like an eyelash curler is just an eyelash curler. I don't. I find that when I use a better eyelash curler, my lashes stay curled for a lot longer. Okay, so next thing, I got two nano lip liners by Sephora, and I gotta wipe my hands off so I can swatch these for you guys. But I really like the nano lip liners because they're small. This is what the full size looks like right here. They're only $5 though, and they have a really nice array of colors. And so I tend to buy these when I'm looking for a lip liner to go with a specific lipstick. This color in particular I bought so that I had a lip liner that would go with the lip tart I bought, and again, this color was called Black Dahlia. So I wanted a color that was going to go really well with that, and this one is called Bordeaux, I think. It's called Beau Bordeaux. How fancy, darling. So I like this one because it's a deep red with a little bit of brown, and it just really complements the color of the lip tar well, and it helps it stay in the lines, especially with a color that bold. I needed a lip liner that was gonna be just moisturizing enough to apply smoothly, but dry enough that it wasn't gonna feather out and that it was gonna prevent the lip tar from feathering out. This one does that job, and it was only $5, so you can't go wrong with that. So while I was on the Sephora website, they were talking about how orchid was the color of 2014. So naturally, I had to get some orchid things. And I wore this lip look in my last video, and you guys were asking about it. I actually filmed a tutorial for it, but the lighting was absolute crap and you couldn't see the color, so I might try to refilm that during the week or something while I'm getting ready for work. But these are the colors that I used. This is by NARS, and this is the Velvet Matte Lip Pencil, and the color is called Never Say Never. This is a really beautiful, perfect orchid color. It is absolutely gorgeous. It's not picking up as well here, but trust me, this color is so stunning. I will go ahead and swatch this on my blog so you guys can really get a sense of what this color looks like. The problem that I have with matte colors a lot is they're too drying, and this one, it glides on really smoothly, and it's matte, but it's not drying, which is absolutely perfect for me. It was pricey. I think this one was $22 as well, but $22 well spent, which I'm not really surprised. I tend to really love NARS anyway, so I'm not surprised that I like the product. And I bought another nano lip liner by Sephora. This one, obviously, I've used a lot more. And I bought this one to go with that lipstick that I bought from NARS. And I just wanted a color that was going to be orchidy enough to go with it, but not too purple, not too pink. And this lip liner is perfect. This color is called Lovely... What is it? Lovely Lilac is what this is called. And it matches and blends just so beautifully together. And I really love this. Again, it's like the Bordeaux. It's a little bit more moisturizing. I don't really have any feathering with this, but I thought that I might have had it when I first got it just because it's a little more moisturizing, but it glides on really smoothly and it matches really well with the NARS color. And I, again, will swatch all of this on my blog so you guys can get a better sense of what this is supposed to look like when there's not crappy lighting outside. Okay, so the last thing we're gonna talk about, and I know I really didn't have that much to talk about this month, but you gotta understand I was sick for over half the month, so I really didn't do a whole lot of shopping. So this is actually pretty impressive because I did all of this in 2 weeks, okay? So this is by L'Oreal, and it is the Infallible Black Buster Liquid Eyeliner, and it is a jumbo eyeliner pen. So I really like this. I was kind of on the fence about whether I was gonna like it or not because I really like to cat eye or just like wing out my eyeliner, and I was a little concerned because this is obviously a jumbo pen and it's so huge that I was like, well, how is this gonna be in terms of control? It's actually really good. I like the color. The color is very, very black. It almost looks like a Sharpie, and I really like that because I love the look of black eyeliner. And it is, okay, so I'll put it like this. If you are a beginner with liquid liner, then I wouldn't recommend this because this is something that you have to be really flawless with your application in order for it to work. I have been doing liquid eyeliner for a really long time. Like, I'm talking years and years and years. So I have really good control with the pen. So for me, it's perfect. I don't use this when I'm trying to get a very thin line just because I feel like the felt tip is a little too large to control when you want a really fine line. But since I normally go for a thicker line, I don't have a problem controlling this. If I'm gonna do a very fine cat eye, I'll use a finer felt tip. But this is really good when I want to do like a thicker cat eye, and it's actually really easy. I just have to do a couple strokes and I'm done, and I don't have to do a lot of like filling in or anything like that. So if you're experienced with liquid liner, then I highly recommend this. So that is it for me. Those are my favorites for the month of January. I will go ahead and do a tutorial for the Orchid Lips probably next time. So probably within the next couple days. And any other tutorial you want to see, let me know if you want to see a tutorial on the Orange Lips. I don't know if you really need to see me do the process, but if you want to, let me know in the comments down below. Don't forget to follow me on Instagram and Twitter and keep up with my adventures and misadventures when I'm not filming videos. I am on my way out to the Super Bowl party now. So I love you guys so much. I hope you enjoy your Super Bowl Sunday, and I will see you in the next video. Bye.